I think it's important to send the boys down into the grounds because it's where you're getting it from. You have a bit more respect for it in the sense that I've had to go outside in the pouring rain, in the mud, to go and pick it all, come back, wash it, and then produce it to the kitchen. When my client comes to me and they come into the restaurant and eat, it's about an experience, it's just not about something that's on the food. The group of people that actually work here, we all sing from the same hymn sheet, we all trying to achieve the same goal. Doesn't matter if we're in the catering sector of this club or it's for the sports facilities, whether it be the squash or the tennis or golf, we all want to have a five-star experience when we turn up here. I'm doing a lamb belly, it's loin and lamb belly, and then I've got a lamb fillet to go with it. I've rolled it and I've seasoned it, I've added a little farce to it, and I've done two course cooking process. I've almost poached the lamb. A lot of people sous-vide the lamb, so the old school ways have pretty much poached it, so I've poached that lamb for a little bit, and then I'm going to re-roll it and then pan fry that, so I get a nice good shape out of it and the colour's correct and I get the two-tone colour from that. Along with that I'm doing a spring pea puree with peas and broad beans. And I've got lamb fat potatoes. So when I render down the lamb, so when I make my sauce and I'm rendering down the bones and the lamb, so I use all the cuts of the animal. So I'm using all of the stuff that you might throw away or it might go into a mince. I'll try and use that in my sauce, or I try and reuse it so there's nothing wasted. I'm rendering down the lamb and I'm using that in my potato with a little bit of smoked garlic on top of that. And with that, I'm having a Pedro Jimenez smoked lamb jus with that. So it's a little sherry base, so it just cuts back a little bit of the fat as well within that sauce, and it sits quite well. So with all the food that I try and do, it's about having a bit of theatre. So it's not just what's on the plate, it's an experience about it as well. I tend to put a lot of other things with it. So I'm smoking this dish, so when it comes to you, use all your senses. So use your eyes, your nose, your mouth, and you get all those senses that come to you. So I'm producing a smoke with that, so it helps with the lamb dish, but it also helps with when you pour over the Pedro Jimenez smoked lamb jus, it has a hint of that with it as well. The smoke element is a theatre to it, and it's something a little bit extra. And if you've got that equipment at home, fantastic, but you haven't, you can produce that, no problem. For this dish here, I haven't used the technical bits of equipment, okay? So the sous-vide machines and the thermomixers and stuff that I've done it the original way, purely because you don't have that in your kitchen at home. So this dish, you'll be able to replicate it. If you've got a bit of clean film, you'll be able to produce the dish, because all it is a bit of rolling, but it's a technique of rolling and how hard you roll it and get the right sort of shape, but holding the shape, and the way that you cook it once and then you chill it back and then you debag it and then redo it again. A lot of people don't know where this food comes from. Kids come in to me and I say, oh, what do you think that's in the field? And they'll say it's a fox. No, actually it's a cow, and these are the type of cuts that you get for it. For the chef's point of view, I think it's really important. I've worked with my butcher for about 15 years. I don't really change. I change products and stuff, and I'll try other things, not a problem, but I generally have the one butcher that I've been with that understands me in a sense. So when I get a bit of meat up, I would ask for six of them so I can choose the best one out of it. It's all about the carbon footprint at the moment and where it all comes from. People like a little story that goes with it. I used a little bit of Kentish lamb, so if I was going to do the lamb side of it and I wanted to use a mushroom cust, I would go to Romney Marsh lamb, because that has an earthier taste to it, and with the mushrooms on top of that, with the crust, it blends in. So, and I'd use different lambs for different dishes as well. So, and it's important for the butcher to realise that and where I'm coming from. I'll ask him, I'll say, this is what I'm doing for the menu, and I'll ask him if this is what I'm having. And he'll say, oh, do you want to use this lamb from this area or this lamb from this area? So then I'll get a choice of that.